Hi everyone, today we're going to learn how to deploy and use Minio on CloudStation. But first, let's answer a simple question. What is Minio and why use it? Minio is a high-performance, software-defined object storage system. In simple terms, it's like a super-efficient digital storage locker for your data. Here's why you might want to use it. It's great for storing and retrieving large amounts of unstructured data, like photos, videos, log files, or backups. It's compatible with Amazon S3, so you can use it as a cost-effective alternative to cloud storage. It's scalable, secure, and can be deployed anywhere, on-premise, in the cloud, or even on the edge. Now, let's deploy Minio on CloudStation. First, you need to log in to your CloudStation account, and if you don't have one, you just need to sign up using GitHub, Bitbucket, or Gmail. I'm going to sign in using my Google account. Once you sign in, you might want to create a new project for this Minio storage. Hit create and then go to add new and choose templates. And here, look for Minio. Click on deploy and you don't have to change anything. So CloudStation is going to create a user for us and we will be able to access it from the variable section. So here we have the Minio root password and Minio root user. Once it's deployed, CloudStation is then going to create a bucket and create a public policy for us so that we can easily test it. So just give it a few minutes. I can see that the application is live, and when I go to the logs, in the logs we see here that we are able to access the API from this URL and the web UI from this URL. This information is also available from here. So once I click here, I will be able to check out the Minio instance, and here it is. So here's my root user and the password. And I can see here that CloudStation has created the bucket CloudStation in here. And if I go to the bucket here, I will see the policy, which is public, that is it. So if I were to upload a file, let's say CloudStation logo, I will be able to access it and to preview it. For Minio, there are two access points, the API and the web UI. Server URL is this one. If I want to update it, let's say server, save changes. I will need to also update it in here. In order to be able to access it. Let's redeploy with the changes that I have made. So if I want to access the file that I uploaded earlier, and there it is, it's public. Now we can create other buckets in here, like, so let's say this one, I want it to be private. I can activate versioning if I want to. Versioning is gonna allow me to upload the same file multiple times, and it's gonna keep track of the version. And I can also activate object lock-in, which is gonna prevent from deleting the files on the bucket. But I'm gonna leave it as is and create the bucket. And here, so by default, it's a private bucket. So right now, if I go to this one and if I upload the same file from earlier, I can access it from this link right here. I can download it, but if I want to access it, I go to is denied because this this one is private. On S3, you can subscribe to events that happen on the bucket, and the same thing is available on Minio. And all you have to do is create how you wanna receive notification of the events. Let's say I wanna just do it through webhook. All I need to do is create an identifier and the endpoint for the webhook. So let's just say so I can take this webhook URL and just use it here. We need to restart the server. And now, let's say I wanna subscribe to the events on this one. All I have to go is go to the bucket, events, and then subscribe to events. And here choose the webhook. And let's say I wanna subscribe to the creation. If I upload something new to the bucket, I'm gonna receive notifications. But, and that's it. And now all I have to do is go and upload something new. And here it is. I see here that I get the webhook notification. There are other features that are available, like for example the site replication. So if I were to deploy another instance of Minio, I can connect it to here and have two replicas. And you can see other features in here. If you want to scale your Minio instance, for example, add more RAM or more CPU, you can do it from here. So I can give it, if I know it's gonna need more, so I can just give it more RAM and more CPU from here. And that's it. That's how you deploy and use Minio on CloudStation.